advanced mode. In this lesson, which is indeed the penultimate lesson in the portfolio course from the future, we'll cover two critical details: how to update the portfolio as we add or change out clients, how to choose which projects are featured on the homepage, and how to selectively include certain sections in our project pages.
McGuire, I'm going to stop you right there. Why? Because it's three steps, not two. Just to make that clear. It's been obvious since we started the outline and the production. I don't know why you said two steps. It is three steps. Me and Stacy have been very clear on that from the very beginning. So make it three, please.
Fair enough. Let's start with the first. We're in Megan's portfolio. Let's go over to her projects, and we're going to add a new one. And since Megan is fictional, so is her client. We'll call it New Invention. For a brief project description, I worked with the team to create a new invention. It's patented. So please don't try to steal it. Project image. Drag this in. Alt text for the project image. Pink abstract art. Project color. 631064. Project type. This was, let's put it under UX design, project year 2021. Client name, invention client. Project details, let's paste those from our clipboard. Project link, google.com. Project images, we'll drag from off screen. As a reminder, if you don't do it now, make sure before you publish to add proper alt text to each of these. And when we're ready, we're going to press create. Now, just like this, its status just changed to stage for publish. And here's what that means. It means that the moment we publish our project, that project will go live based on the design we used for all our other projects. So we can explore that, but as an alternative, we can also go in and schedule this, or for now, save it as a draft. And if we save it as a draft, it won't show up when we publish, but we do want this to show up, so let's go in. We're going to stage it for publishing. And let's close out before we publish. Let's take a look. Right here, we see we have the new invention based on our design from before. Let's go in, let's go to preview mode and click View Invention Client Project. We can see our page is working properly. We have the multi-image field, and it links to our other projects. But notice what's happened here. Our design was for a three-column, three-across design, so we could make a few changes here. And that leads us to part two, how to limit or selectively display certain projects. So here we are. Again, we're in the projects page. We can always go in and we can limit items. Just add a limit. Right now it's showing 100. We can make this two, but that doesn't work as well as three. And now it'll show three across. But we have a problem. It's only showing three. There are four client projects. How do we choose? Well, we can do a few things. Let's go in to filters. Right now we know that the current project, this page that we're on, which is new invention UX design, we know that the current project won't show up because the filter is filtering out the current project. But of the four remaining, we can choose a sort order. We could say, based on when we created the CMS item, when we added this, we could go in and say created on. We can say we want newest to oldest. And to better prove that, let's go to another page. Let's go to our investment app. At the bottom, our newest project will show up first. So that's sorting. But there's another way to do this. And while this may work for our other projects on our project pages, let's go back to our homepage because we now list all five of our clients. We might not want to list one or two of them. How can we control that? Well, we can do it with a switch. Back in our CMS, let's go into our CMS, let's go to settings, and we're going to add a new field. Add field, switch. We can say either featured or even not featured. Let's turn this one to featured on homepage. Save field. Let's move this up to the top just to keep things organized. Let's save. And let's say we want to choose three of our projects to feature on the homepage. We can choose our new invention. Let's press save. We can choose our architectural website. Let's press save. And let's also feature the investment app. Featured, save. We'll close that out. Now, they're all showing up. We can still see all five. But what we can do is we can select our collection list wrapper, and we're going to create another filter. Let's create a filter based on that switch. So we'll go in, featured on homepage. We want to make sure that switch is on. Let's press save. And it looks like nothing happened. but it did. We can see we have the new invention, architectural website, and investment app, and nothing else. Now, what if we want to flip this? What if we want to feature the things that aren't switched on? Well, we could just go in and featured on homepage is off. Save, and now we'll see the other two where the switch is flipped to off. For now, we're gonna go back and switch this to on. Part two, part three, what if we want something to show up only on some client pages? For this example, we'll use a testimonial and we'll build it out in the project pages. We'll go to the project's template. And what we wanna add is a testimonial section. So we'll scroll down, we'll put the testimonial, let's say in between these two sections. So we'll go to our ad panel, grab a section, place it in between the two existing sections. Let's create a new section type based on our existing section. So we'll use section and we'll say combo class, testimonial. And what we'll do different on this section is we'll grab its background color. We'll get the background color from the project color. That means, like we've come to expect, as we switch between these projects, we'll see that background color match the project. And we want to add a couple things here. We want a quote in the testimonial and the person who said the quote, probably associated with the client. Let's go in and add a paragraph element. This will be the quote itself. We'll call it quote. Select the section. Set its font color, let's say to white. And let's assume these are shorter quotes, so we'll add a period here. Then it doesn't really matter what we put in this design because we're going to replace it with dynamic content from our CMS. But for now, that looks pretty good. Let's go in, add a container. Let's put this inside the container. And let's add one more. We'll add a text block. And this will be person's name. But it doesn't matter. Again, we're going to replace it in just a moment. Let's style this. With our container selected, let's create a new class where things are centered. Let's go up and turn on flexbox, vertically stack, and align to center. Of course, let's make sure our text alignment is also centered. Centered container, and let's style this. We have DM serif display. Let's set our line height to 1.2 hyphen, not pixels. And let's increase this, holding down option to drag and increase. That looks pretty good. Let's add some margin at the bottom. Let's do 30 pixels for right now. Actually, what would be great is if we split these two. Let's remove the spacing underneath and we'll make sure this has no margin on the top. And what we'll do is we'll add a div block, a divider, command K, div block. And this will be a height of 1, a width of, let's say 150 pixels, and let's set its color, its background color, to white, but with a lower opacity. Just a little accent divider. And what we can do is we can add margin on both sides. Let's say 30 pixels on both sides, maybe 15 pixels. And what we could do, since it's looking a little short, we could select the section and add some padding on the top and bottom. Let's do 100 pixels. And if that's the design, we can control this in the CMS, and then we'll choose conditional visibility in just a moment. First things first, in the CMS, let's go to our settings, and we'll add a new field. Let's make sure we choose plain text. Let's say it's a multi-line text, and we'll say this is the client or project testimonial, optional quote from the project. You can put a minimum character count, maximum character count. This is again optional. Let's save this. And let's say add one more field, plain text. This can be short. This is project testimonial by optional. Put the author of the quote here. And we'll just press save. And now we can go in. Let's say for our new invention, we had a testimonial. Working with Megan Garcia absolutely changed my business. I had no idea what UX design even was. Now my company is worth billions. By Evan Hendry. Press save. And now for new invention, we can replace this. Again, this will work on any page, but because we've only added it to one of our collection items, one of our projects, let's go to that page so we can design with that data. Let's go to New Invention. Let's scroll down to this section. Let's replace this quote. We're going to get the text from Project Testimonial. There's that quote. Person's name, we're going to grab the text from Project Testimonial By. Now, everyone's thinking the same thing. Those quotes are incorrect. Let's fix them. Into our CMS, New Invention. Let's highlight our existing quote. On Mac, this is Option Left Bracket. And the closing one is Option Shift Left Bracket. Let's press Save. Escape. Much better. But here's the awkward part. While it shows up here, Evan said this quote for this client, for this project. If we go to Investment App, we have this awkward blank spot. There's no data. We haven't added a testimonial. And it's like that for some clients, for some projects. We don't have a testimonial. So how do we get this section to only show on pages that have an actual testimonial? Let's go into our section, and we'll just go over here to our element settings, and we're going to add a condition. Again, the section is selected. Let's add a condition, and we want to select our project testimonial because we want this to be visible when the project testimonial is set. In other words, if there is a project testimonial, we want to show this section. If there isn't, don't show this section. If we press save, it should disappear. That's the expected behavior, and it disappeared. So if we go into architectural website, it's not there. If we go into new invention, there's Evan's quote right there. And if we go into our CMS and we go to projects, and let's say we go to investment app, and we do have a quote, quote by person, let's press save, close. And now if we go to investment app, scroll down, there it is, quote by person. The section will only show up when we've added a testimonial in our CMS. And again, it'll match the color, the background color, to that CMS item. But that's it. We updated our portfolio by adding another client, another project. We covered how to choose and limit which things showed on the homepage. And we covered selective elements, conditional formatting on our project pages. Greamer?
That is indeed my name, Cut to Black. Now cut back to me. That's right. It's the guy at the end of each part of this course telling you about hashtag 21 day portfolio and how we've seen some amazing stuff shared so far. I'm also an avid golfer, I'm pretty good at soccer, and I recently watched The Queen's Gambit on Netflix. The cinematography, the acting, the writing, sublime. Why am I telling you this? Well, I couldn't find any natural way to bring up the fact that I have chess trophies, and this felt like the smoothest transition from topic to topic. Remember to share your portfolio, we'll be sharing our favorites throughout 2021. Now cut back to black.
Okay.
Should I just not cut to black that much, or I kind of like the control. I feel like I'm in control of the edit.
No, that's good. It's great. Yeah. You're doing great.
Okay. Just keep going. I love it. Yeah. I'm just asking you. I don't really care either what you said. I'm going to keep doing it.